What's up, you guys? Jason Wardrop here, and in today's video, I want to show you how to generate 100 to 200 organic leads per day for your GoHighLevel digital marketing agency. And this is from part one of a three-day live workshop I did for GoHighLevel. I did it for the whole company and showing my exact system broken down step by step. And so this is day one. I'm going to do day two and day three. And I plan on each one of these trainings only being about 30 to 40 minutes long. And when I did them live, we got sidetracked on a lot of different tangents, different stories, there's a lot of questions. So they ended up being about 2.5 hours long each day, which I don't know if you guys have been following me for some time now, you know that I like to get straight to the point. I don't like to go off on different tangents, even though I happen to do that a lot of times, but I like to get straight to the point of like what actually you need to be successful. So enough of that, let me just dive in. I wanna pull up my slides and give you this presentation, how I want it to be delivered, a lot more short, concise. So if you're like, man, I don't have 2.5 hours, even on 2-speed to go through, going through all this training, I wanna be able to deliver the same value, but maybe in like a shorter, condensed version that you can go through and take and implement into your own business. All right, so here we are. So the title of this presentation was a three-day live workshop I did for the entire company of GoHighLevel. We had tons of people on. I know day one, the Zoom holds 1,000 people. We max out in like the first 5 minutes. People were trying to get in. We had another 700 people on Facebook, and then it's had thousands of views outside of that afterwards. So I know this has been a hot topic. I know a lot of people always want to know how to generate leads without spending money on ads, how to get consistency in your business. So title of this presentation, without further ado, how to get 100 to 200 organic leads per day for your SaaS agency. And for those of you guys brand new to the whole GoHighLevel world, SaaS stands for software as a service, basically running your marketing agency or your GoHighLevel business like a software platform, and be able to do this even if you have no following and no money for paid ads. The reason why I think this topic is so important, even though there's a lot of other topics we could have covered, is because you have to generate leads at scale if you want to win at this game. And without marketing, you have no leads. Without leads, you have no sales. Without sales, you have no revenue. And without revenue, you have no business, right? Just a really expensive hobby. And I know a lot of people, they mentioned out to me and they're like, you know, Jason, I really got to get a client. I got to make this work because I can't afford another $500 per month payment. And I get that. And so I want to be able to give you guys the blueprint to this lead machine to be able to never second guess and wonder where your next lead is coming from. You know exactly what to do to make this happen. All right. And if you stick with me here to the end of this training, I'm going to give you guys all my templates, scripts, SOPs, that's kind of stands for standard operating procedures, how to make this work, sales funnels plus 4K in courses. And I'll show you guys how to get that here at the end of this video. All right. And so this blueprint, what I'll be showing you, is going to help you grow your email list where the money is in the list. You've probably heard that a number of times, but it really is in the list. And that's what's really key and important here. It's going to help you grow a Facebook group, an Instagram following, a YouTube following, a TikTok following, any of those like kind of vanity metrics. If you want to be a social media influencer, this is going to help you easily do that. And then also most important is going to help you grow your SaaS or your software agency's revenue, which is really kind of the end goal of all this, because that is where the money actually starts to pour in. And all that being said, we got to remember Kiss, right? And not the band. I don't actually ever listen to Kiss. I don't know any of their songs, but the acronym, keep it simple, stupid, right? And that's actually why I'm redoing this training, because I'm like 2.5 hours long. That's not simple. That's a barrier to entry. Some people look at that 2.5 hours and like, I don't even want to watch that because it's just too long. So I wanted to go through and redo this so you can see how simple this really is. And as you go through these next few days, you'll see that my business is actually pretty simple. I've really broken, I've eliminated all the things that might add complexity to my business, because I not only want to make money, I want to create an amazing lifestyle that I can actually enjoy my time and the money that I'm making, right? And so you'll see that throughout this whole presentation here. Now, for those of you guys who are brand new here to my channel, brand new to the whole GoHighLevel world, maybe stumbled upon this video, who am I? Why would you even believe me or trust me on any of this stuff? So my name is Jason Wardrop. You can see here, this was me speaking at GoHighLevel's first event. This was like a year or two in Dallas. I've been in the digital marketing game for over 10 years now. In 2015, I started my own real estate CRM software company. I grew that to over 15,000 paying clients, exited that business in April of 2021. And then mid-2021, I started promoting a HighLevel as an affiliate. And I've actually now since making the slides like 2 weeks ago, I'm at over 20, I think I've just passed 28,000 referrals to HighLevel, making me the number one all-time, number one referring affiliate for HighLevel. And so that's a little bit of my background, but basically the reason why I'm sharing that is like I've been down the road a little bit. I've got some experience doing this. I know there's a lot of people out there saying a lot of things, a lot of so-called gurus, people trying to make their way in the beginning, and that's great. I was there at one point too, but I've been through the ropes. I've kind of seen a lot of what works and what doesn't work, right? And not only has this worked for me, but I've also shared with a lot of other people, and it's worked for them. And this is just a handful of testimonials that we've got from people who've going through my programs that I've helped coach grow their own agency as well. Now, quick disclaimer, this is just one way that's worked for me, okay? And it's worked for a whole lot of others, but not saying it is the only way, okay? There's a lot of ways to go through and grow your business. But for maximum results, you want to stack what I'm about to show you over the next couple of videos with other client acquisition strategies. Now, the reason why I love what I'll be showing you in the next 30 or so minutes is because it uses what is my best friend, and that is leverage, okay? In order to have maximum scale, you have to have leverage. And leverage is leveraging your time, because you as a solopreneur can't do this all alone. It's leveraging media or social media, all these different advertising networks, and then also leveraging software to automate a lot of these repetitive tasks, and then also leveraging the monthly recurring revenue component that software brings. And honestly, leverage has been my best friend for the last, I'd say, 8-9 years of running these businesses, because with my real estate CRM, it was just me. I didn't have any sales team. I did all the sales. I did all the marketing. Got over 15,000 paying clients. With being now a HighLevel for affiliate, I haven't had any sales or marketing team. It's been just me, and now over 28,000 referrals. And I'm not saying that to go like pat myself on the back, but it's because I've understood these concepts of leverage, and I want to show you guys these concepts as well, so you can go through and implement them into your own business, or if you're looking to start your own business, be able to take advantage of them as well. Right now, who is this training for? Who should be actually watching this? Any entrepreneur. You don't have to just be a marketing agency owner, just someone looking to start their own software business or go HighLevel. Entrepreneurs looking to get consistency and predictability in their business. Right? And I think that should be like almost every entrepreneur out there. Consistent leads, consistent sales, predictable outcomes. Knowing what your end goals are. Let's say you want to make 100K for your first time in 2024. Well, let's not just go put out some like hopes and dreams of like make 100K or make your first million or whatever it is, but let's reverse engineer the things that we need to do to guarantee that you're gonna get those results, because it's the inputs that we do on a consistent daily basis that are gonna give us the outputs that we're looking for. And then also consistency of knowing what actions can we take to know that we're gonna get leads and sales on a consistent ongoing basis. All right, so there's four key things that you need to win. And in this video right here, we're gonna cover the first two. And then if you guys are subscribed, which, you know, I ask that you guys subscribe, click that subscribe button down below. We just passed 200,000 subscribers. Super cool. But you'll be able to get notified when we release the second and third video, which is going to be consistent lead flow and the follow-up. Right now, I know you guys might be looking at this and be like, well, Jason, specific audience, you need a rock solid offer, consistent lead flow, follow-up. That, you know, everyone says that, it's so cliche, but I guarantee you guys what I'm about to show you is different. And the reason why I know it's different is because based on the business model that I have set up, based on the numbers that I'm producing, all of the top gurus, all the names that you see on YouTube, all the people that you see on Instagram, they've all reached out to me on DMs and they ask me, what am I doing? How are you setting this up? Even big time business owners that are like, man, I would much rather be in your situation than in the situation I'm in, right? So that is why you need to go through and set this up in a systemized, simple way so that you can grow in a way that you actually are going to enjoy your business, enjoy your work, and be able to step away and still have that money coming in. So I'm gonna show you how to systematize everything. Never wonder what you should post, what you should email, what you should offer to people, and just give you a very straightforward blueprint, all right? Now, before we dive into all this stuff, you know how I like to keep it simple. This book is called The One Thing. It's by Gary Keller. I highly recommend it to anyone looking to go through and grow as an entrepreneur in business. And this was like, when I read this book, this was the big shift in my entrepreneurial journey that I felt like took me from like kind of just dinking around, just kind of like being a wannabe entrepreneur to being an actual legit entrepreneur and having success. So I read this in December of 2015. I was actually on my honeymoon. And the whole concept of this book is basically any category of your life, which I love, like, love talking about this, especially right now in January, because everyone's setting their goals, you know, a couple weeks ago, probably set their goals. They have their, you know, New Year's resolutions, all these things. And you've got like fitness, you got finances, you got family, you got spiritual, social, you got all these different categories. And if you strip it down, a lot of times people like make these long lists of all these things they want to accomplish, which honestly can kind of bring in some overload, bring in some anxiety, and like, I don't know, like you get a couple weeks in and you quit because there's just too much to do. Whereas this concept right here is what, in each one of these categories, what is the one thing, if you stripped away all the other things, if you focus on one thing in fitness or finances or family or health or whatever it is, and you just focus on that thing, what's gonna make everything else irrelevant or way easier? And this is a practice that I do on a monthly basis with my business. And it's not like a routine monthly, but it's probably every 3-4 weeks that I just kind of sit back, got a little massage chair in my office. I sit there, I think, I write things down. I've got all these big whiteboards in my office, and I just write down what are the core things that actually move the needle. And here are the core things that I have found over the last, you know, several years of doing this that have really moved the needle, especially in the last 12 months for me. And you might look at this and be like, well, Jason, that's not one thing. And Jason, that looks like it's a lot of stuff to do. And also, you said that we didn't use ads. And ads on that third one on the daily, that was just one I kind of threw on there because if you want to accelerate things, then obviously it's a way to accelerate your lead generation. But every single day, I like to have one piece of short form content. I like to send one email. I like to have ads running because then you just have consistent leads coming in. And that's obviously like, it's not required, but something to kind of like go and just like put the cherry on the top with stuff. And then every week, I like to have one value YouTube video, and I like to do what is called a splinter promo, which we're going to talk about in the next video. So make sure you're subscribed, hit that notification bell, and you'll get notified when that video drops. Now, you might be looking at all this stuff and be like, well, Jason, you said keep it simple. This is just like making my brain explode, all the complexity of making a new piece of short form content every day, emails, all like I can't do this. Like, how am I supposed to do this every single week and still do all the things I'm supposed to do in my business? I've got a family, I've got kids, I got all this stuff, and I get it, okay? I'm gonna show you guys how to simplify this and make it a whole lot easier than it may look, okay? So let me just show you how this works. So what we're gonna be covering, day one, which is today, nailing down your specific audience plus a rock solid offer. Day two is the consistent lead flow, how to create systems to automate and simplify lead generation without spending money on paid ads. And then day three, proven follow-up systems to get consistent, predictable results. All right, so let's dive into this. And this is obviously, this is a live train. So I said, who's ready? You know, type in the chat, you know, which obviously if you want to comment down below, that would be awesome for the YouTube algorithm there. Okay, so step number one, specific audience. I learned this when I was running my real estate CRM software business I started back in May of 2015. And I'll be honest, back in May of 2015, I was not thinking it was gonna be a real estate CRM. I didn't think it was specific to real estate because what I was doing at the time before that, I had a marketing agency and I was working with all different types of clients. And my thought was, you know, why is there, like, you have to have a landing page for your clients, you gotta have a website, you gotta have email marketing, you gotta have a CRM, you gotta have all these different tools. And now, especially with HighLevel, it's a lot more commonplace to have an all-in-one software solution. But back then, it was not. And I was like, why isn't there one tool that has all these put together so we don't have to have sign up all these different softwares and subscriptions? And so we set out to build this tool. And we started building it out, and I thought, you know, this whole concept of landing pages, marketing, all this stuff, it works for any type of industry. It doesn't matter if you're a dentist, a chiropractor, a real estate agent. And so I'm like, this is gonna be awesome because we can go through and sell to any type of industry, any type of business. However, this is where I learned it's really key to have a specific audience in mind, because I went and I would talk to the dentist and I'd be like, look, we're gonna do all these cool things. We're gonna generate you leads, bring in business, bring more patients, all this cool stuff. And he's like, well, what other dentists have you had on the system? I'm like, oh, you know, like we got this, you know, chiropractor over here, or whoever. And he's like, well, come back and talk to me when, you know, you got some other dentists. So we go to the chiropractor, same thing. Who are other chiropractors? Real estate, same thing. And so we kept running this issue where I'm like, man, I feel like we've had some success with some of these agency owners, or like as an agency owner with some agency clients. And so we've built out the software, but man, we just can't get that traction. And then one day, it was actually my wife's idea. She's like, well, you've had some good success with real estate agents, and it seems like this would be perfect for real estate agents. And so why don't you just go after real estate agents? And so I was like, all right, we'll give it a shot, because nothing else was working at the time. And at the time, I was doing a lot of things. I was meeting in person with trying to do sales in person, trying to do sales online, phone call. Like I was doing like everything. But also one thing that I was doing was webinars, kind of just presentations, trying to general business, how to go through and grow your business. And I was selling our software for an annual subscription of $300 at the time. Very cheap. It was just me as a naive business owner not really knowing what to do. And so when we went to real estate, I was like, you know what? If I help a real estate agent close a deal, they're going to easily make 10 to 15 grand because they're making 3% commission on the value of the home, right? And so I was like, this is easily worth $1,000, because even if like $1,000 for the year, even if they close one home in the year, like they're making their money back like 10 times that. And so I went, rewrote the webinar. Instead of being like general business, I made it very specific to residential real estate agents, not real estate investors, not commercial agents or anything like that, residential real estate agents, and primarily solo residential real estate agents. And I 3X the price. I took it from 300 for the year to $1,000 for the year, more than 3X. And my conversions at the end of the very first webinar skyrocketed. I remember I had four sales, so I brought in $4,000. And I remember after that webinar, I felt like the richest person on the planet. Even though $4,000 really is not even that much money, I was like, man, I have figured it out. I know it's real estate. I just have to scale this thing. It's connecting. I didn't even have that many people on. I had probably 40 people on, sold four people. I just got to scale this bad boy. And so that's where I learned I have to have a very specific audience so I can have all of my website copy, my marketing messages, my emails, my ads, all speaking to a very specific audience. And then also be able to show testimonials and case studies of other people who are just like them, who have already had success, right? And then when I dove into the high level game of being an affiliate, I was like, you know, this is perfect because I already know who my avatar is. It is someone looking to start a marketing agency. And I was like, this is awesome because I'm going to go broad of just like how to start a marketing agency, because you could be insurance, mortgage, chiropractic, dentistry, doesn't matter. So I was like, I'm just going to go broad with anyone starting a marketing agency. And so I went through, built out a webinar, because that was kind of like my expertise. That was the one thing. That was the one thing I decided. I was like, if I just learned webinars, everything else is going to be so much simpler and things are just going to actually work for me, right? And so I built a webinar speaking to this marketing agency audience. And what I noticed over the next 60 to 90 days, this is back in 2021, was literally 90 to 95% of people buying, they all bought and they said, hey, I know you're the real estate guy. What, like, how did you grow your real estate marketing agency? Like, how did you get clients? What were you doing to fulfill for clients? Like, what were, like, give us the blueprint. And I was like, sure, okay, like I'll kind of make some trainings because like, you know, it's pretty easy, like what I did, I'll just show you everything. So I went through, built out the entire course, like redid it for like the real estate angle, very specific to real estate. And people were going through that and like, oh my gosh, like I can't believe you just like gave us the plug and play business, like literally everything that you did. And I'm like putting this in my business, it's working so well, I can't even believe you did this. And so I was like, man, I really should rewrite the webinar being real estate agency specific, but I'm like, that is too niche. Like, I don't want to go that niche. Like, there's not any scale in that, right? But I was like, you know what? I've got some time. It was like over Christmas break, and I was like, this is literally like 2 years ago, and I was like, I've got time. I'll go do it. So I went through, rewrote the webinar, made it very real estate specific. Real estate agency. You want to build a real estate agency? Here's how you get real estate clients. And man, I released that webinar and that converted better than any other webinar that I have ever launched. And it was because one, I had the experience, obviously, and I knew what to do. but it was very micro niche. So not only was it a specific audience, but it was a very specific audience within a specific audience, right? And that thing for the next year and a half, I mean, still today it converts amazingly well. Next year and a half, that thing, like I'd pump in like only like 30 grand a month in ads, and that thing would kick out 60, 70, sometimes up to $100,000 in a month. With rev or cash collected month one. So it like worked amazingly well, right? So how to go deep with your audience? Well, you need to understand their pains, their goals, their worries, their struggles, their successes. So if you look at that, we've got pains and worries and struggles on one end, and then we've got goals and successes, their aspirations on one end. So you need to understand both polar opposites, right? And if you are your ideal client, it makes this so much easier, right? It works either way. But like, for example, I was never a real estate agent. And so it was a little bit tougher to sell to real estate agents because I never was them. But I still was very successful with it. However, when I transitioned and I was selling to agency owners, teaching them how to start a real estate marketing agency, and I'd already done it and I already had all the accolades and all the experience and all the success and be able to show results, man, that made things so much easier. Not only because I had the results, but because I understood my avatar and I understood what they were going through and I knew what I had gone through and I could be able to relay that to them in the marketing messaging, right? And so what you wanna do is you wanna read books about how to become better at real estate or insurance or mortgage or whatever the industry is. So like for me, that book, The One Thing, it was a real estate book, right? It was by Gary Keller, who started Keller Williams. There's, you know, the millionaire real estate agent shift. There's a lot of books. So I would just read those. And so then I would be able to understand the language that they would use to be able to help people become a better whatever they were, right? And then I would study ads, webinars, sales copy, emails of other companies and other influencers that were competitors, not to copy and steal what they were doing, but just to understand what is the angle that they're going after? Why are they saying this? What is like? What is the purpose of bringing them with this hook? And then what is something on the other end that this hook is gonna be able to deliver what solution and what's the value that I can take out of this, right? So I would just study all of that. And the great thing is like any industry, you're gonna have a lot of different influencers or competitors that you can go through and study and just kind of see. And there's a lot of resources and tools like the Facebook Ads Library that you can go find a lot of that different stuff. Okay, and one thing that I did, I put together for you guys, which if you guys hang with me here to the end, I'll be able to show you how you can get a 50% off account to Go High Level for the first 3 months. And I'll actually hook you guys up with my client avatar prompts. This is a doc that when I first got started, I never took this seriously. I never was like, man, all this bogus. What keeps your client up at night? I'm like, oh, who cares? But now the more I get into this, I'm like, man, that is everything. What does keep them up at night? If I can make my marketing message actually speak to them, it's gonna just click so well. So I've got all these prompts that you can actually throw into ChatGPT. And if you're like brand new to your audience or like to your industry, it's gonna help you. It's gonna go scour the internet, be able to help you kind of come up with your ideal client avatar right here. And so I've got all these prompts, it's a Google Doc, plus train on how to go through and do that when you get started with High Level. I'll have the links down in the description, or just drop a comment down below if you guys want this, if you guys want the link to get High Level at 50% off for the first 3 months, and I'll hook you up with that link, all right? Now, remember, this was something I kind of came up with right before we went live last week with this presentation. Broad for show, niche for dough, okay? Every time I go to a High Level event and someone's trying to impress me, I'm like, what niche are you going after? Oh, we don't have a niche. We go after everyone. Like, yeah, we can work with anyone. We're like mass scale, all this. And I'm like, okay, you're probably not making any money. You probably don't really have anything figured out. And I can always tell they're trying to go through, you know, go broad for show because like, oh man, Podium or Weave or all these different businesses, they're all broad. They work with anybody. But guess what? In the beginning, they didn't. They were very niche and that's where they made the money. And then they were able to grow from there. Okay, so remember, broad for show, niche for dough, right? Write that down. Now, step two, one rock solid offer. So now that we got the audience, we need to make an offer to this audience. And I used to think backwards. I was used to like, oh, you need an offer first. No, you can't make an offer unless you know who the audience is, right? And so what I like to do is have just one simple sales funnel. I don't like to confuse this thing, like make this all tough and have all these different book sales funnels and high ticket and all this low ticket funnels. I just have one, right? And so this is it. And you might be looking at this and be like, well, Jason, I'm not an affiliate. I'm not teaching people how to make money. That's great. You just change the language to whatever your industry is. So like this one is just one variation of the landing page copy that I have, but how to make 5 to 10K per month using AI. I have another one, how to start a software company with a no-code software company, or how to start a $5,000 per month marketing agency. And so there's a lot of different angles. Or like if you're in the real estate space, you'd be like, how to generate 2 to 5 real estate leads per month, okay? And then you send them to a simple VSL and then send them to the next page, which we're gonna talk about that here in just a second, okay? Now, why a landing page? I know a lot of people like watching this, you might know what a landing page is. You might not know why we use a landing page, but there's a lot of beginners I know that watch this and that were on the workshop the other day. They're like, what is a landing page? Why do we use a landing page? Well, if you look at this, on the left-hand side, that's HighLevel's homepage. And a homepage is more educational purposes, right? It's more informational. Someone's going there to log into the software. They're trying to study and understand, what is this business? I'm trying to like figure some stuff out. It's not set up to convert website visitors into leads. Whereas a simple landing page, like you see right on the right-hand side of your screen right here, this is very clear, it's concise, and it is set up in a way to convert website visitors into leads. So with that, if you look here, a website, and this is any industry, doesn't matter what it is, it's usually gonna have about 1% of visitors that visit that page turn into leads. Whereas a landing page, you can get 25 to 30% of visitors, even sometimes higher depending on the audience you're targeting and the messaging and all that stuff, if you're using a landing page. So I don't know about you, but for the same amount of traffic, I would much rather get 25 to 30 times more leads than what I would be getting with my homepage. And then, once we'll talk about day three, the whole follow-up, which obviously the fortune is in the follow-up. Now, let's break down real quick the anatomy of a landing page. So if you look right here, number one, the most important thing is the headline, okay? The headline, and then number two, the call to action. So the headline is the main jump, the thing that jumps out at them. It's the big promise, it's what they want, right? And then the call to action should be related to getting that. So like, get started here, download now, get the free case study. And then number three, it addresses the audience, right? And right here, this is where I kind of contradict myself, because this one's like going for a little bit more of a mass market, which I know I just said don't do that. But you might look at this page and be like, well, Jason, you're not addressing your audience. Down at the very bottom where I say 100% beginner friendly, that is my kind of mass market broad, like calling out to the audience. Look, it's beginner friendly. Whereas if it was more like real estate or insurance, I would say, for real estate professionals, I would have something like that calling out. So it's like, hey, how to generate 2 to 5 real estate leads per day, which obviously already kind of calls out to real estate, but have something like that in there. Number four, what's offered, right? At the top in red, I've got 100% free online course. And you might look at this page and be like, well, Jason, this page is too simple. It is simple, and that's why it works, right? And this is a variation of this page, is something I've used for probably over a decade now. And I know a lot of people are like, oh, you saw that from Sam Ovens or this and that. I'm like, before I even knew who Sam Ovens was, I was using like this exact same style of page, right? And so we've got what's offered, we've got KISS, keeping it simple, and then I'm kind of covering it up down there at the bottom, but one of the most important things is making sure that it's mobile friendly. If it's not mobile friendly, if it doesn't adjust when you pull up on mobile, which a lot of us are building on our computers, you're gonna get roasted, because 90 to 95% of people visiting your website are gonna pull this up on their mobile device. All right, now, what information should you actually collect? Now, I mainly like to go through and collect only the information that I actually need. And the less information that you collect, the higher the conversion rates, right? So if you just wanted their email, obviously you're gonna get a lot more people going through and opting in. However, if you're just asked for the email, sometimes a lot more people are gonna put in just bogus information. So what I like to do a lot of times is have their first name, because then I can use their first name in the emails, the follow-up emails in the subject line, and also when I'm addressing them in the body. Their email address, obviously, to be able to send emails. And then also a phone number. You guys might remember that like I'm not going through building big sales teams or anything like that, but I like to throw a phone number in there, not because I'm gonna be calling them. I'm not even texting them a lot, honestly. But I like to have it in there because usually it's gonna push away a lot of the tire kickers. So this is gonna increase the quality. Yes, it's gonna lower a little bit the conversion rate on the landing page, but I'm fine because I'm getting enough people there that I only want the best, highest quality leads. And yes, still some people are gonna put in bogus information, but I'm fine with that because if I'm getting this core information, usually I'm getting a little bit better info. right? Now, the confirmation page is very simple. So we've got a headline, we've got what is called a VSL or a video sales letter, and then we've got the call to action button. And in this case, I have the call to action. You can see I've got two different variations here, literally the same page, same structure, but the call to action is a little bit different. The one on the left is for a 30-day free trial to HighLevel, which I'm promoting HighLevel as an affiliate. Same concept works though if you're white labeling HighLevel for your own business. And then the one on the right-hand side is a no trial, but it's gonna give them a done-for-you basic account setup, right? So it's kind of like a little bit different offer, a little bit different angle. You can see in the hook there. On the left is semi-passive income. On the right is building your own AI agency. Now, what are we offering in this video? Okay, what we can offer is we can offer software, obviously because we're white labeling HighLevel, and software has massive value when we go through and offer software to our clients. We can offer templates. Templates that we can pre-build and just put right into the software. Makes it very simple to deliver at mass scale. We can offer courses or coaching, but you see I have right here, know your audience. A realtor is probably gonna want a course and they're probably gonna want coaching. That's why there's like a billion real estate coaches out there online and influencers, whereas you're not gonna have as many dental coaches or dental influencers because they don't want a course, they don't want coaching. They just want things done for them, which leads us in the next step, which is done for you. And I can tell you every industry, no matter what it is, they all want done for you. Even if they're tech savvy, they want done for you. They don't wanna go through and have to figure things out. They just want it done. But all of these things that we're offering, they all need to be focused around getting the desired end result. And one thing that's gonna be consistent with no matter what industry you're talking about is sell to simplicity. How are you making it simpler than what their current state and what they're currently doing? How can you create automation to then save them time and save them money with what they're currently doing? And then ultimately, how can you make a better offer than the competition, right? And that was one thing that I learned first when I was selling my real estate CRM, because everyone, I remember when I was starting it, they're like, that's stupid. Why are you starting a real estate CRM? There's so much competition. There's already so many other bigger, better players and they've got way deeper pockets than you. And I was like, cool. And that was mainly because I was just naive and stupid, but I was just naive and stupid enough to then go in and keep at it and make a better offer than what all the other real estate CRMs were making. And then same thing with HighLevel. I didn't know that in the affiliate game, you had to create a better offer than all the other affiliates, or even if signing up directly with HighLevel, not under an affiliate, right? And so I figured out, how do I create the number one best offer to my affiliates and be able to deliver upon the things that I'm offering, and so that people want to sign up with me versus the next person, right? Now, this video sales letter, this is not something like I went through and studied any type of like video sales letter training. I'm sure there's a lot of other trainings that are a lot better than this. This is just something I've learned from doing YouTube videos for like the last 5 years or so and understanding like what keeps people hooked onto the videos and what gets people like jumping off quicker. And so basically what it is like if the whole title of the video is like, you know, here's how to generate 2 to 5 real estate leads per day. You start out, hey, today I'm gonna show you how to generate 2 to 5 real estate leads per day, right? There is like the bold promise, the bold claim. And then every time you make a bold promise or bold claim, you want to back it up with proof and results, because everyone else is calling BS. They're like, nah, right. They're like, you can't do 2 to 5 leads per day. I'm getting 0 leads per day. How can you possibly do that? And so then you go in through and show, let's say 3 to 5 different case studies or testimonials of yourself, or yourself and others, or just others, depending on like if that's the business you're in, right? It's like, yeah, here's Sally, here's John, here's, you know, Maria, here's all these people that are all, you know, all the results they're getting. So now they're like, okay, cool, interesting. Like, you know, you made this big promise, you showed us some results, and then I'm also gonna show you how to duplicate it, right? So like, oh man, okay, so like 2 to 5 leads per day, that sounds legit. He just showed us all these testimonials, and then he's gonna show us how to duplicate this? All right, I'm hooked. I like wanna watch a little bit longer. And all this has happened in the first like 30 seconds of the video, right? And say, and give you, insert the bonuses. And that kind of goes back to that offer page, right? Offer bonuses of a free course, depending on your audience, or templates, or blueprints, or follow-up emails, or whatever, coaching, done-for-you setup. When you call to action, when you get started with a free trial, when you get jumped, click the button below and jump in and get started. Whatever the call to action is, right? So that's all in the first 60, maybe 90 seconds, depending on how long it takes you to go through and hit all that. And then you have a content section, maybe 5 to 8 minutes, depending on how long it is. but you want to show how simple it is to achieve the desired end result. So we're saying here's how to get the 2 to 5 leads per day. Here's all the people. Plus, if you get started today, I'm going to give you these bonuses when you act now. Let me show you actually how to do this. And a lot of people give pushback because they don't want to go through and show people how to do this. However, that's kind of like the opposite mindset. People, they want to see it, and it's fine showing them everything, okay? Because they still need the tools to be able to go through and make this happen. And then you just close. And so after you've shown it to them, show them how simple it is, how they can duplicate it, show them the templates. Hey, just, you know, they're like, oh man, I totally could do this. And they say, yeah, so if you want to go through and get 2 to 5 real estate leads per day and get these cool bonuses I've got for you, then just click the button below and get started, right? That's literally my whole video sales letter structure. It's not that intense, okay? So quick recap, day one, we need to hit a specific audience, one specific offer, one simple sales funnel. We need to keep it simple and run from there, all right? So basically, if you guys, I've got all these cool bonuses. If you guys are brand new to High Level, you're actually gonna be able to get 50% off your first 3 months of the software. Just drop a comment down below. We'll share with you guys that link. Or if you guys are already on High Level and you want to upgrade, also drop a comment down below and I'll share with you guys the private link that you guys can upgrade through me. And you'll be able to get this sales funnel template clone. You're going to be able to get my AI avatar doc plus training. And then two programs that I have, my real estate agency accelerator. This is going to be for a very limited time and for a limited number of people that we're going to be giving this out. But it's my blueprint of how I got over 15,000 paying real estate clients, plus the fulfillment blueprint, how I did that all. We only ever had a team of 15 people max, so we were using massive leverage. And then also my affiliate Cashflow Academy course, which I actually don't even sell that anymore. It's only for my affiliates. And I know that makes a lot of people mad. It made a lot of people mad on the workshop the other day, but just kind of the way it is. I don't want to be able to go through and teach everyone. And I'm not even charging for that. So it's just a freebie giveaway for people jumping in and sign up under my link. So drop a comment down below. Hook you guys up with that. Hope you guys enjoyed day one. Look at that. We're like roughly 35 minutes into it, whereas the other one was 2.5 hours. So if you 2X speed this, you know, you're 15, 20 minutes. Got pretty much the same amount of content. And if you guys have any other questions, drop them down below. Happy to go through and respond to any of the questions. If you get some like cookie cutter response, that's one of my VAs. Sorry. I'll go and I'll try to respond to every single one of them individually myself as well. So that you guys can get what you guys are looking for, what you need. Thanks so much. Make sure you guys subscribe, hit that notification bell so you could be part of day two and day three, the more short condensed versions of these. And honestly, those days are really exciting because day two, we're gonna talk about that consistent lead flow, how you can actually start getting those organic leads coming in. And then day three, the follow-up, which the fortune is in the follow-up. That is where all the money is made. This stuff is cool. It's a foundation, but that is where all the money is made, all right? So anyway, guys, thanks so much for watching and I'll see you in the next video.